Whenever it comes to life insurance, which policy to choose is a big question. And whenever we speak to life insurance agents, they always propose to, you know, propose us an endowment plan. Why do they propose an endowment plan? Why not a term insurance plan? So which one to choose? Is it good to go with a term life insurance plan or to go with an endowment plan? So I will answer you this question in a very simple way. Let us first understand what is a term plan and what is an endowment plan. So a term life insurance policy gives you pure coverage, and this is the pure term life insurance. So this doesn't give you any saving, any investment opportunity. It is like paying salary to your security guard. You hire a security guard, you pay him a fixed monthly salary. In case if there is any attack on your house or your office, he will protect you. If someone comes to rob your house, he'll protect your house. But in case if there is no attack, if you ask him to pay back the salary, he will not pay you. So similar way, term life insurance plan gives you coverage against the risk of death, which means you agree to pay the premium for, let's say, 30 years. Your current age is 30. So for the next 30 years, an equal amount of payment, same amount of premium you pay. And at the end of 30th year, that is your age of, you know, 60th age, in case if you're absolutely fine, you're very much alive, insurance company will not pay you anything. But there is a chance. Say for example, you have taken a crore rupee coverage. The premium may be 8,000, 9,000 or 10,000 rupee. You paid 1 year premium. Suddenly some accident happens and you are no more. Your family will get 1 crore rupee. Just by paying a premium of 10,000, your family will receive 1 crore rupee money directly into their bank account. See the difference. But in case of endowment plan, it is completely different. For a crore rupee coverage in endowment plan, you'll have to pay a premium of nothing less than 4-5 lakh, even if you're going for 25 to 30 year term. Such a big amount of premium. Imagine the difference. For a crore rupee term insurance coverage, your premium, if your age is about 30, is 10,000 rupees. If you are currently aged 30, the premium varies from, there are some companies that are offering even 7,000-8,000 rupee. Some companies may go up to even 18,000-20,000 rupee for a person who is aged 30. But in endowment plan, for someone who is aged 30, for a crore rupee coverage, the premium will vary anywhere from 3.5 lakh to 5 lakh rupees. See the difference. So which means, after you take an endowment plan, let's say you're paid 1 year premium, suddenly death happens. You will get 1 crore rupee coverage. I mean, your family will get 1 crore rupee, but to get that money, you have to pay a premium of 4 lakh rupee. But in case of term insurance, it is just 10,000. 40 times more. The premium difference in endowment and term is 40 times different. The next important thing here is, when it comes to buying a term plan, this is just a coverage. Endowment plan gives you saving element in it. So which means in term insurance, the benefits you will receive only upon death. So your family or your legal heir or your nominee will receive the sum assured, the committed value of sum assured upon your death, demise. In case of endowment plan, even if you don't die, if the policy matures, let's say you have taken a term endowment plan with a 30 year term or 20 year term. At the end of the term, you are absolutely fine. The sum assured plus all the applicable bonuses, whatever is accumulated, you will receive it. So which means it is clear, term insurance is a pure life insurance policy. In case of endowment, it is an insurance plus saving plan. Now the question is, what returns you get in endowment plan? Okay, it is good to save money, but is it worth saving in an endowment plan? The returns you get in an endowment plan is nothing more than 6.5%. The maximum you may receive about 6.5. Best cases you may receive 7%. You tell me, don't you have better investment opportunities than investing in endowment plan for just 7% return? So what is the best way then other than this? You can invest the same money in a mutual fund or a property or something else which even PPF gives you 8.5 kind of returns. NSE, National Savings Certificate, gives you better returns. So why don't you go for that? There is absolutely no sense to go for an endowment plan for saving. So then why are we all buying this? This is not bought by us, this is sold to us. Unfortunately in India, insurance is not bought, it is sold to us. Life insurance is always sold to us. So why do they sell endowment? Why not term insurance? See, in the Western countries, insurance companies are tracked, measured based on how many people they cover, how much of coverage they give. But unfortunately in India, insurance companies, especially life insurance companies, are measured based on the premium they collect, which is bad. So what happens today? For a term insurance, if they have to sell a term insurance plan, a person has to have a decent income. So for example, somebody's income is 1 lakh rupee, the maximum term insurance coverage he can avail is 20 lakh rupee. If your annual income is only 1 lakh, you can take 20 lakh rupee term insurance coverage. But a 1 lakh rupee salaried person, 1 lakh annual income person, can pay 30,000 rupee annual premium and buy an endowment plan. But in term insurance, for 20 lakh rupee coverage, your premium will not be more than 4,000 rupee or 3,000 rupee. So why an insurance company or an agent would be interested in selling your term insurance? You tell me. They want to take more money from you and they would always propose you to buy an endowment plan. So please don't go by that. Endowment plan will cost you more, at the same time will give you very less returns. Instead, go for a pure term life insurance plan. Pay a simple premium, whatever is required, based on your income. Say for example, there is something called human life value calculator. It is available on indianmoney.com website as well. Human life value calculator will tell you what is the coverage you need. And this is based on your current age, your current income, your outstanding liabilities. For example, my age is 30 and I currently earn 5 lakh rupee annually, which means my coverage, the as per thumb rule, is 14 to 15 times of my annual income. If my annual income is 5 lakh, I should have coverage worth 5 lakh into 15 times, which is about 75 lakh. Plus, let's say I have a home loan of some 20 lakh rupee pending. Then it's good to take a coverage of crore rupee. Now, if I ask for 2 crore rupee coverage, will I get? No. Insurance companies will ask you to furnish your IT returns and income proof at the time of giving your policy. So you will have to have, you know, the desired income. Otherwise, they will not give you some unexponential coverage just like that. So it is important that you have a income, and based on the income, you can go up to 20 times of your annual income and take the coverage. Now think about, you have taken a pure term insurance policy. Let's say your age is 30, you're earning 5 lakh rupee annually, you've taken a crore rupee coverage. It costs you about 8,000 or 10,000 rupee. What do you do with the rest of the money now? If you have, let's say, 50,000 more to invest, instead of buying an endowment plan, put this money in mutual funds. Put this money in, worst case, if you're looking for safe investments, debt funds in mutual funds. Otherwise, you can even go with National Savings Certificate or PPF. Those gives you better returns. I'll tell you why these insurance companies and agents are selling endowment plan, not term insurance. One, as I said, it is because the commission, the premium they have to charge, the premium you pay for term insurance is very less. Endowment can be very high. Depends on your affordability. But in case of endowment, there is another important thing. The commission agents get is very, very high, almost double. If a term insurance gives an agent 15% commission out of the first year premium, endowment plan may give 30-35% as well, which means he is going to earn double commission. So why do you want him to be rich from your hard-earned money? So it is wrong to buy an endowment plan just because an agent is forcing you to buy. And the other important problem I have noticed in India is, most of the time, whenever we collect, whenever we buy a life insurance plan, we are not ready to accept the fact that we are going to die one day. So because of that, this weakness of ours has become the marketing strategy for these agents and salespeople, even the insurance companies. Because of that, they are selling endowment plan. Let us accept the fact, one day we will die and we don't know when. Since we don't know when we are going to die, it is important and it is our responsibility to ensure our loved ones are safe even in our absence. And it is for that reason that we must have a term insurance policy to ensure that when we die, they only suffer from the emotional loss, not from the financial loss. If you don't buy an endowment, a term insurance policy with sufficient coverage, in your absence, they will suffer both financial and emotional loss. Emotional loss of, I don't have my father, I don't have my husband, or I don't have my wife, is something no one can bear it. No one can compensate. But the financial loss of the income which husband used to earn or a son used to earn can be compensated through term insurance policy. And nowhere an endowment policy can compensate that, because it can't give you that kind of coverage. If you have to avail that kind of coverage from endowment plan, and if you can afford it, you really don't need a term insurance plan. So point is, always go with a term insurance plan, and whatever extra money you have, invest in mutual funds, property, NSC, PPF, or other options. Now coming back to choosing the right term insurance plan. This is something very important. I have spoken about it earlier as well, and I will share with you the video link in this video. Please visit my next video and understand how to choose the best term insurance plan for your family. Also, read my book, Love Beyond Death, which creates awareness about term insurance plan. Love Beyond Death is a fiction with a powerful message. When you read this book, I'm sure you will get a lot more, in-depth understanding of the necessity of buying a term plan to protect the future of your loved ones. Thank you so much. Please share this video with your friends and family so that they do make wise decisions. And please leave your comments in the below comment box so that I will be able to answer it personally next time. Also, subscribe to IndianMoney.com YouTube channel to receive regular financial education videos. Thank you so much.